Hello there, Pirate Sports fans. My name is Ryan Clayton, alongside Dylan Camp. We are here at the Prudential Center after a Pirates victory. They just took down the St. John's Redstorm by a score of 77-68. Dylan, we'll start from that first half. What did you really see in that first half?
You know, the Pirates got off to a pretty strong start. They were shooting much better than St. John's early on. And then kind of late in that first half, as St. John's started to apply pressure to the Pirates, they got really sloppy, started to turn the ball over, started to shoot less efficiently. And that was kind of something we've seen over the first couple games that I didn't like at the end of that first half. They started really, really well. Towards the end of that first half, they got a little sloppy, but they went into the locker room with the lead, which was a very good thing. One of the few halftime leads the Pirates have had so far this year.
That's right. They have had struggles in that first half, but this one looked very good for the Pirates. You already started to get into it, but towards the end, it was an all-out shootout. I mean, the threes kind of were slow in the beginning, but towards the end of the half, both teams were hitting the mark. What did you think of that?
Yeah, it was great to see the Seton Hall Pirates finally make some threes. They started, I think it was 0-7, and then they made three of their last four going into the locker room. It was Kale, and then I think Mamu hit back-to-back threes on two possessions. So that was great to see. You know, St. John's hit some as well. They were really trading blows. So it was a very exciting end of the first half, and I was glad to see some three-point baskets finally fall for the Pirates.
All right, so that brought us to the second half, and just going by the stats, it was a Mamu kind of night. Do you want to talk about the night he had?
He was so impressive. I think he was one rebound away from a double-double, which is unfortunate, you know. But he put up a career-high 32 points. He was incredibly impressive. He really took control in that second half. And my favorite thing that I saw out of him was he was getting a lot of tough layups to go in. He was really fighting through contact, got to the free throw line and punch, but was making those and-ones. And I think that's what helped the Pirates pull away.
Yeah, he really drives like a guard at times, which is so impressive. You know, he was talking about that in the postgame a lot. Speaking of the postgame, you had the opportunity to tune in via Zoom. Is there anything that stood out to you from the players or Coach Willard?
What stood out to me from the players the most was how much respect and excitement they all had for watching each other's games. You know, first Miles Kale talked to us, and he was talking about how great Mamu had played. And he was just saying how Mamu was like a brother to him, and he loved watching that. And then he talked about Tikal, and Mamu talked about Tikal. So it really seems like a strong brotherhood in that locker room. It seems like they really all want each other to succeed. So that was great to hear. And even the excitement on Kale's face about Mamu's game was really cool. So just watching them be so excited for one another after a great game like they just put on against St. John's, it gives me a lot of hope that this team will have good chemistry moving forward.
Yeah, the chemistry definitely seems like it's there. And you heard from all the players that, like, it was a team effort. So that is something great to see. Next game up for the Pirates will be against Marquette. That is going to do it for me, Ryan Clayton, alongside Dylan Camp here for Pirate TV, signing off.